What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. My name is Bailey Kramer, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you exactly how I use Notion to run my Airbnb and midterm rental business. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump in. So first thing first, what is Notion? So Notion's like a project management tool, very similar to Monday.com, Trello, Asana, ClickUp, or if you've never heard of any of those, you can think about it as a really high-tech version of Google Sheets and Google Docs. And I'll show you exactly how I use everything in a second. All right, so I just got in my account. I'm going to show you all the different ways I use Notion in my business. You might not use every single function that I'm showing you here, but I promise you, stay till the end because I'm going to be showing you every functionality and I know for a fact that you can get something out of it. All right, so I'm going to start on the top here, the daily checklist. So for my Airbnb business, I have a virtual assistant and every single day she has this daily checklist that she'll go through at the beginning of every single day. So for example, responding to any unanswered messages, sending out follow-ups on inquiry messages, check calendars availability to make sure that no dates are accidentally blocked off, checking the batteries on all the smart locks, and a bunch of other tasks that she has to do on a daily basis. The second thing I do here in Notion is I have a task checklist. So whenever I want to import a new task for my virtual assistant, whether it's Airbnb related, YouTube related, or anything of that nature, I'll put it here in the not started tab. And then whenever she's working on a task, she'll put it in the progress tab. And then when she's done, she'll put it in the done tab. So this is just like a good project management tool that I use. That way I know exactly what she's working on. So this is literally my virtual assistant's shifts. And once I get more virtual assistants, I can add them to the calendar, but I can easily see when she's on, when she's off, and she's actually off today. So this makes it really nice to give a good view of scheduling, training, and support documents. So this essentially goes through everything that she needs to do for a guest before they book, when she accepts the booking, during their stay, post-checkout. These are essentially standard operating procedure, how to run everything for my properties. Another thing that I have her do is hit the like and subscribe button. Oh, wait, what? Who put that in here? Another huge part of Notion is I have property pages for all my properties. So essentially what happens is whenever I onboard a new property, I fill out this page and it lists all the information that anyone needs to know about the property ever. So if a guest asks us a question, the answer will be in here, whether it's what type of air conditioning do we have? Or if a guest is locked out, we'll have the backup lockbox codes. And literally any question you can think of is in here. And if it's not, we add it to it. All right, and then moving on, we have a bunch of other documents and templates down here. So example, like our property organization template, this is basically what we copy and paste and then fill out. The daily and weekly checklist, I already mentioned, this is like all the tasks she goes through every single day. We've got some ChatGPT commands. And what's really cool too is they have an entire template library. A lot of these are free too. So you can look up if you're looking for a specific thing. If you want this to be your CRM, for example, they have a ton of options here of essentially pre-built CRMs that you can plug and play or really anything that you're thinking. The world is your oyster. And one other thing, and I know this is the most important question that people ask is, Bailey, how much does this thing cost? So they have a free plan, which is what you can start on to start out. I'm personally on the plus plan, and I think it was because I ran out of storage or something on the free plan. And that was after I had, I don't know, a dozen or so properties. So I moved over to the plus plan. It's $8 per month per user or $10 billed monthly. But again, in my opinion, you could have everything I showed you on Google Drive for free. But I just think that Notion makes it super easy because my VA can have access to it. And it's super easy to access it on the phone as well. So do what you want with this information. I hope you guys got some value out of it, and I'll see you in the next one.